The egg of bird in only a single cell, an ostrich egg measure 170 mm into 160 mm is the largest single cell. The smallest cell is a bacterial cell. It measures 0.00001 mm into 0.0005 mm. So, see, the smallest size of cell and the largest size of cell, their variation is from 170 mm into 160 mm to 0.0001 mm into 0.0005 mm. Okay, the smallest cell in the human body are red blood cell. They are all about 0.007 mm in diameter. A typical cell is all about 0.02 mm in diameter. It can only be seen through the powerful microscope. We are not able to see with our naked eyes. In plants like jute, hemp, the fiber cell are few centimeters long. An amoeba is a unicellular organism with no definite shape. In pseudopodia, which help it to move and feed, keep appearing the disappearing. Okay, so this is all about variation in shape and size. Let us talk about another important topic, which is structure. So cell varies so much in their size and shape. They have a number of things in common. The basic component of cell are cytoplasm, cell membrane, nucleus and organelles. So basically these four things are common in each and every cell of all living organism. I repeat, cytoplasm, cell membrane, nucleus and organelles. You can also see a typical cell, the structure of typical cell, which are present in which you can able to see a typical shape in which vacuoles, nuclear membrane, nucleus, mitochondrial, cytoplasm and cell membranes are present in their structure. Let us talk about each and everything, whatever I told you, cytoplasm, cell membrane, cell wall, nucleus, cell organelles, one by one. Okay, first cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is a jelly like substance that make up most of the inside in cell. So basically whatever the hollow shape, whatever the remaining shape are present within the cell, they are only filled up of cytoplasm. They are basically structure is jelly like structure, and all the life function take place in cytoplasm. Let us talk about cell membrane and cell wall. Surrounding the cytoplasm is thin covering, which is said to be cell membrane or plasma membrane. So we can also say that the outermost covering of cell is cell membrane, or which is also known as plasma membrane. Okay, the cell membrane separated cell from its surrounding because it is the outermost covering. Okay, it protects the cell from giving it a shape. However, it allows water, minerals and some other necessary substance pass through it. You just think about it, if anything is a boundary of it, anything is a covering of a substance, obviously without their permission, we can't able to move a substance outer to inner, inner to outer. So whatever the substance come in the cell, only cell membrane or plasma membrane allow or permit. Plant cell have cell wall and their absence of animal cell. So cell wall is only present in plants, not in animal. Okay, so cell wall is also outermost covering of cell. Plasma membrane present, the outer part of plasma membrane is cell wall. Okay, there are two layer of outermost covering in plant. First one is plasma membrane and second one is cell wall. Okay, in animal cell, this cell wall is not present. The cell wall support and protect the plant cell, since the plant do not have a skeleton for their support. We know that in plant, skeleton is not present. They have absence of bones, but in animal, skeleton are present to giving their strength or support. That's why in animal, cell wall is not present, and in plant cell wall present to giving support. Okay, presence in a cytoplasm are a small structure which is known as organelles. Okay, We talk about organelles in next lecture after talking about nucleus. Let us talk about nucleus. Floating within the cytoplasm in a center, a small spherical body called nucleus, or the plural of nucleus is nuclei, are present. So within the cell, a circular or a spherical shape of body present, which is said to be nucleus. In most of the cell, one nucleus are there, and most of the cell having more than one nucleus are present, then we say nuclei. Okay, the plural of nucleus is nuclei. The nucleus is control the center of cell, and it directs the growth of cell and control all the activities that go within the cell. Whatever the activities performed by a cell, they all are controlled by nucleus. Okay, it can therefore be compared as the brain in animals. So whatever the function of brain in our human body, they control each and every activities to taking decision, to performing any activity brain allow to perform any function. Similarly, nucleus allow to perform activities, they control all activities. So we can say that nucleus is a brain of a plant cell. Okay. The liquids in the nucleus is known as nucleoplasm. So nucleoplasm is a liquid present in nucleus, and it is separated from cytoplasm by thin nuclear membrane. Okay. So some cell present nuclear membrane, and in some cell or in some organism nuclear membrane are not present. Okay, on the basis of nuclear membrane, we classify organism into eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. In eukaryotic cell, cell membrane are present in eukaryotic cell, and in prokaryotic cell, cell membrane are not present. Okay, the nuclear membrane is a porous and allow the movement of material within the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Present inside the nucleus is the smaller spherical body, which is known as nucleus, and also the present nuclei is a thread-like structure, which is known as chromosomes. So within the cell, a thread-like structure shape is said to be chromosomes, and these carry genes within contain the all information needed to the cell and that transfer from the parents to their offspring. So whatever the genes present in your body, that is the copy of your parents. Okay, so genes is the information that comes from your parents. Okay, so parents transfer their information or characteristics to their offspring by the help of genes, and these characteristics is the complex of body, the shape of the color of eyes, free lobe, closed lobes, nose, the structure of body, height, color of hair, these all are the characteristics which transfer from parents to their offspring. For this lecture, it's enough. In upcoming next lecture, I will teach you more about this chapter. Thank you.